1. NK nuclear target shooting major cities, military bases, and the White House are among the top potential targets in the North Korean nuclear strike, an eye-opening report has revealed. Major U.S. cities, the island of Manhattan, the White House, and the Pentagon remain big targets, while Guam and military targets were next. South Korea also makes the list with military bases in Pyeongtaek. The commercial area near Camp Humphreys coming ahead of Seoul as another potential target. Right now most of these NK targets are wishful thinking on the part of NK, especially targets located in the US mainland. However, they are advancing their nuclear arsenal with every test, so who knows how far along that they will be in a year or less. And from reports that I've read, MK is working on a submarine that would be capable of moving a nuclear-tipped missile with an accurate striking distance and then launching an effective nuclear strike on the US mainland. Plus, however, according to the Zambian Observer, Russian President Vladimir Putin, North Korea has no nuclear weapons. America after mineral reserves. Plus, but Russian President Vladimir Putin also said, as reported by USA Today, that North Koreans would rather eat grass than give up nukes. So which is it? Plus, and going further down the rabbit hole, the National Review says that the real culprit behind North Korea's missile threat may be Vladimir Putin. Plus, and Korea nuclear weapons are here to stay, says expert. 2. California rocket man. A California man intends to launch himself 1,800 feet high on Saturday in a home-built rocket to prove that the Earth is flat and that astronauts faked the shape of the Earth. The rocket should travel about a mile at a speed of roughly 500 miles per hour. Looks more like a publicity stunt than real scientific research to me, and no, I don't think that the Earth is flat. Group of underscores, 3. A sticky wicket. The US plans to keep its troops in Syria long after the defeat of ISIS, the goal used to justify their illegal presence in the first place, because the Syrian government and its ally Iran would win if they were withdrawn. US officials say they plan to maintain a US troop presence in northern Syria and establish new local governance, apart from the Assad government, in those areas, as reported by Root News. No more fighting ISIS? The US to stay in Syria to prevent win for Assad and Iran. The reason that the US is there isn't about fighting ISIS, and never was. The US is there for regime change, and the US media keeps going on and on about Russian election meddling in the US presidential election, like the US doesn't meddle in foreign governments, elections, and regime change so that they can put in their own puppet rulers. The US has always displayed a high level of hypocrisy when it comes to such issues, war and foreign affairs in general. Plus, meanwhile, the US imported terrorism to the Middle East, new Philippines president says. Plus, finally, the BBC outs US/ISIS complicity in Syria. Plus, and according to the Russian insider, Putin-Assad meeting cements the end of US dominance in the Middle East. Group of underscores, 4. Will the US dollar collapse in 2018? It's really time to start wondering, will the US dollar collapse in 2018? It's no secret that, over the course of the past 3 decades or so, the US dollar has dropped by some 25%, compared to its rivals in the currency markets. Whether by design, President Donald Trump claims he wants a low dollar, or by accident, the US dollar index has lost about 10% in 2017. This trend can only continue and likely accelerate in 2018. And now, the dollar is about to collapse. Plus, 21-point prepper's checklist for stocking up at Walmart. Plus, prepper tools that I use and recommend. Plus, the quickest way I know to get a family of 4 prepped for the coming collapse. Group of underscores, 5. Economic warfare. The United States may be a military superpower, but foreign leaders know how to hit it where it hurts. Russia is already working with China to set up an apparatus that would allow oil sales between the two nations to be conducted using the yuan instead of the dollar. Sergei Glazyev, an advisor to Vladimir Putin, has explained that Russia is negotiating such deals in a bid to bring about the collapse of the US economy. As soon as we and China dump the dollar, it will be the end of the US's military might. As reported by Andrew Miller in The Trumpet, Iran urges Russia to ditch US dollar. Plus, here is why Russia might decide to crash oil prices in 10 days. Group of underscores, 6. Pulling out the old war and out race card yet again. A Seattle, Washington Black Liberation Group is planning a Black Friday march to urge people to only shop at black-owned businesses this Friday. As seen at the Daily Caller, Black Liberation Group vows to shut down Black Friday shopping to fight racism? Laugh out loud. Fighting imaginary racism by being racist. I guess that it makes sense to them. My beef is they, instead of having free will to be racist towards white folks, they should be called out for what they're and treated the same as if they were operating under the banner of the KKK, because they are the same. Plus, how Obama brought back Muslim slavery of black people, America's first black president didn't bring hope to America, but he did bring slave auctions to Africa. After Obama liberated Libya for the Islamist rebels, Arab Muslims sell black slaves for a few hundred dollars at slave auctions. While leftists tear down the statues of slave owners from centuries ago, it was the left that brought back the sale of black men as property. Plus, and on another note, according to the Voice of Europe, Muslims don't want to integrate, they want to take power. Yep, now tell us something that we didn't already know. Group of underscores, 7. Blinded by the light, a new study conducted using satellite data shows that artificial lighting is growing brighter. The data suggests this is disrupting the order of ecological and human life, which previously depended on natural light sources such as the moon. The international study led by Christopher Kaiba of the GFZ German Research Center for Geoscience tracks what researchers are calling a negative trend that has implications for the health of human beings and the environment. Root news, lighting our way to darkness. Scientists warn of too much artificial light on Earth, group of underscores, 8. Delaware, where girls can have a penis and boys can have a vagina and black folks can't be white and white folks can be black. A series of sweeping regulations being considered by Delaware's Department of Education would allow students to self-identify not only their gender but also their race, and it empowers schools not to seek parental consent if the child feels his or her parents might not be supportive enough. The law would apply to students of all ages in all public schools in the state. The Daily Wire. Proposed Delaware education regulation allows children to self-identify gender and race, and without parental consent. Group of underscores, 9. Skynet. Professor Stuart Russell, a leading artificial intelligence AI expert at the University of California, said allowing machines to kill humans would endanger freedom and security. He remarked on the chilling vision following an appearance at the end of a short film which explores how AI could be used to take out targeted individuals. The film, entitled Slaughterbots, shows a dystopian future where tiny drones are programmed to carry out mass killings. By Jamie Bullen in the Mirror, killer robots which use facial recognition before slaughtering people will be devastating to humankind. Group of underscores, 10. The bottom of the news plus 3 cups of coffee a day may have health benefits, BBC News. Plus niece, flea market photo shows Billy the Kid and man who shot him, a photo discovered by a US lawyer at a flea market may be a rare image of Wild West outlaw Billy the Kid and could be 6. Pulling out the old worn out race card yet again, a Seattle, Washington, Black Liberation Group is planning a Black Friday march to urge people to only shop at black owned businesses this Friday. As seen at the Daily Caller, Black Liberation Group vows to shut down Black Friday shopping to fight racism? Laugh out loud. Fighting imaginary racism by being racist. I guess that it makes sense to them. My beef is they, instead of having free will to be racist towards white folks, they should be called out for what they're and treated the same as if they were operating under the banner of the KKK, because they are the same. Plus, how Obama brought back Muslim slavery of black people, America's first black president didn't bring hope to America, but he did bring slave auctions to Africa. After Obama liberated Libya for the Islamist rebels, Arab Muslims sell black slaves for a few hundred dollars at slave auctions. While leftists tear down the statues of slave owners from centuries ago, it was the left that brought back the sale of black men as property. Plus, and on another note, according to the Voice of Europe, Muslims don't want to integrate, they want to take power. Yep. Now tell us something that we didn't already know. Your mineral reserves. Plus, but Russian President Vladimir Putin also said, as reported by USA Today, that North Koreans would rather eat grass than give up nukes. So which is it? Plus, and going further down the rabbit hole, the National Review says that the real culprit behind North Korea's missile threat may be Vladimir Putin. Plus, and Korean nuclear weapons are here to stay, says expert. 2. California rocket man. A California man intends to launch himself 1,800 feet high on Saturday in a home-built rocket to prove that the Earth is flat and that astronauts faked the shape of the Earth. The rocket should travel about a mile at a speed of roughly 500 miles per hour. Looks more like a publicity stunt than real scientific research to me, and no, I don't think that the Earth is flat. Group of underscores, 3. A sticky wicket. The US plans to keep its troops in Syria long after the defeat of ISIS, the goal used to justify their illegal presence in the first place, because the Syrian government and its ally Iran would win if they were withdrawn. US officials say they plan to maintain a US troop presence in northern Syria and establish new local governance, apart from the Assad government, in the One. NK nuclear target shooting major cities, military bases, and the White House are among the top potential targets in a North Korean nuclear strike, an eye-opening report has revealed. Major U.S. cities, the island of Manhattan, the White House, and the Pentagon remain big targets, while Guam and military targets were next. South Korea also makes the list with military bases in Pyeongtaek, the commercial area near Camp Humphreys, coming ahead of Seoul as another potential target. Right now most of these NK targets are wishful thinking on the part of NK, especially targets located in the US mainland. However, they are advancing their nuclear arsenal with every test, so who knows how far along that they will be in a year or less. And from reports that I've read, NK is working on a submarine that would be capable of moving a nuclear-tipped missile with an accurate striking distance and then launching an effective nuclear strike on the US mainland. Plus, however, according to the Zambian Observer, Russian President Vladimir Putin, North Korea has no nuclear weapons. America has rivals in the currency markets. Whether by design, President Donald Trump claims he wants a low dollar, or by accident, the US dollar index has lost about 10% in 2017. This trend can only continue and likely accelerate in 2018. And now, the dollar is about to collapse. Plus 21-point prepper's checklist for stocking up at Walmart, plus prepper tools that I use and recommend, plus the quickest way I know to get a family of 4 prepped for the coming collapse. Group of underscores, 5. Economic warfare. The United States may be a military superpower, but foreign leaders know how to hit it where it hurts. Russia is already working with China to set up an apparatus that would allow oil sales between the two nations to be conducted using the yuan instead of the dollar. Sergei Glazyev, an advisor to Vladimir Putin, has explained that Russia is negotiating such deals in a bid to bring about the collapse of the US economy. As soon as we and China dump the dollar, it will be the end of the US's military might. As reported by Andrew Miller in The Trumpet, Iran urges Russia to ditch US dollar. Plus, here is why Russia might decide to crash oil prices in 10 days. Group of underscores, those areas, as reported by Root News, no more fighting ISIS? The US to stay in Syria to prevent win for Assad and Iran. The reason that the US is there isn't about fighting ISIS, and never was. The US is there for regime change, and the US media keeps going on and on about Russian election meddling in the US presidential election, like the US doesn't meddle in foreign governments, elections, and regime change so that they can put in their own puppet rulers. The US has always displayed a high level of hypocrisy when it comes to such issues, war and foreign affairs in general. Plus, meanwhile, the US imported terrorism to the Middle East, new Philippines president says. Plus, finally, the BBC outs US/ISIS complicity in Syria. Plus, and according to the Russian insider, Putin-Assad meeting cements the end of US dominance in the Middle East. Group of underscores, 4. Will the US dollar collapse in 2018? It's really time to start wondering, will the US dollar collapse in 2018? It's no secret that, over the course of the past 3 decades or so, the US dollar has dropped by some 25%, compared to its